Hello everybody and welcome to my 11th vlog. Wow, what a day today was. Today was rainy day, which is kind of interesting. It hasn't rained in San Francisco for a while, so it was kind of nice to have a kind of cool, wet weather. Even though it was kind of annoying when you went out. Today was an okay day off, you know. Started off kind of weird because I wanted to go out in the morning, I wanted to go explore, but it was raining and pouring and windy, and it was just fucking disgusting outside. So I ended up staying home for the most part. Just hung out for a while, you know, watching YouTube videos, thinking about my upcoming video that I was supposed to make for that contest, excuse me, and I made it. It came out perfect, absolutely perfect, exactly how I wanted it to look. It took me about 3 or 4 hours to make, but that's okay, you know, I don't mind that, you know, I don't mind if it's something that's worthwhile making, it should take a while. I didn't just want to half-ass it or whatever, I wanted to really try, you know, go for it and stuff, and hopefully everything works out, and I'm happy about it. I uploaded this afternoon around 6 o'clock, and yeah, so far so good, I guess. The guy who ran the contest told me it was a good video, so hopefully that's a positive thing, but who knows, I'm not even sure how this thing gets handled. Other than that, it was pretty okay day. I went out with my father, went out with my grandmother, we ran a couple errands, and I was able to go to Barnes & Noble today, and I was able to buy another pop. That's what I wanted to do. Yesterday, my brother had told me that when he went to Walgreens, he saw a blue Spider-Man, I think it's called 2099 Funko Pop from Walgreens, and he saw it. Told me about it, and I told him, damn, you should have picked it up because that's like the last one I need for the set. But you know, he said he didn't think about it, he forgot to tell me about it or whatever, or send me a message. I said, don't worry about it, right? But today, this morning, he went out there before work, before his job started, and he went to go check it out, and it was already gone, which is okay, you know. But the good thing is, right, is that my job tomorrow, we have another ship. And I start early, so hopefully it'll come to our store. And if it comes to our store, I'll probably end up buying it, you know. And after that, I cannot spend nothing else because Wendy's birthday present takes top priority after that. But let me show you what I did find at Barnes and Noble's, which is one of the shittiest fucking bookstores I've ever been to, and one of the shittiest pop places I've been to, aside from not a big fan of Hot Topic, you know. But I had heard and I had seen things online about Barnes and Noble's being this humongous selection when I went there. There was maybe one rack, two racks. Maybe the Barnes and Noble's I went to was a crappy one. But the one on YouTube, the one people go on YouTube, looks great compared to mine. Mine's just nothing there, you know. But yeah, but I found a New York Comic Con exclusive, which was Hawk Girl. It's kind of a nice one, I guess. You know, it was $15, which was a little bit higher than what I wanted to pay. But it retails, I think, on Amazon around between $28 and $40, which is not bad. Plus, it's, you know, it's got that little sticker. That's what it's all about, man. Stickers, limited edition, you know. Truth be told, if it wasn't for that sticker, I wouldn't have bought it because I had a Scarecrow in my hand. And that was a lot cheaper. Well, not a lot cheaper, but half price. So, there's that. But I'm happy with it, you know. I'm happy I finally got some sort of New York Comic Con thing because I've been looking all over the goddamn city. And, yeah. I was happy I was able to find it, which made me feel good. More importantly though, I am very happy today because I actually accomplished that video. I was nervous that I was not gonna make it correct or it wasn't gonna turn out right because, you know, sometimes the software is kind of funny. Plus I do everything on a phone. I have no computer, like I said many times, so a lot of my editing has to be done through an app on my phone. And you know, sometimes it's using a phone and using a computer are two different things. Try writing something on a phone that uses Microsoft Word, or really creating something. It's difficult, it's a pain in the ass. I did that in China. When I flew back from China this past June, I created my resume online there and on my phone, and I sent it out. I didn't apply to Walgreens. I applied when I got home to San Francisco because I needed an actual physical computer to do that part. But, yeah, man, you know, it was something of an accomplishment. I'm really fucking proud of myself because I actually did something and it came through, you know. It has everything in there, you know. I put it on my channel if you guys want to watch it. I even tweeted about it. I put it on my Facebook. So hopefully more than like four people watch it or something, because I do have like something like 23 subscribers, and I just wish I wish folks start watching more, because I think my videos have vastly improved since I was able to kind of master the software. I am going to start doing movie reviews again. That's something that I want to do in the future, but this time with a mixing of the pictures and maybe even a few, you know, small scenes here and there. But let's not get ahead of ourselves, because this is, like I said, this is still just a phone, it's not a laptop, so I'm gonna try that. I'm not sure when, because I actually want to watch a movie, and if I want to review a movie, I have to watch it several times and have time for that. And my work schedule is kind of difficult, so vlogging right now is probably the best thing. Vlogging and doing these smaller projects that take, you know, a day or so to do. Because that last project, even though it was really working, it only took me about 3 hours to do. But I started at noon and finished until 6, but I didn't go out during that time, too. Like, I had to become a hot girl. And so, I feel good, you know. Tomorrow's another work week, another work day. I'm looking forward to that. I know I want to earn some more money. I spent money the last few days, you know. So it's good to earn it back. I don't know, I feel kind of tired now of stuff. But it's a good tired, you know. It's like I feel like I accomplished something today, you know, which is nice. It's always a good feeling to feel like you accomplished something. And I don't know. It's like, I just felt today was just a good day. I just feel good, you know. Originally I was thinking about going to the movies, but truth be told, there's not much I really want to see. All the newest releases so far have been kind of meh, except for Girl on Train. I like that one. I'm not sure there's anything I'm really looking forward to, you know. Maybe that Godzilla thing, that Godzilla Resurgence, but I kind of want to see it, but at the same time, you know, every time I see a new Godzilla movie, I just feel more and more disappointed. I like the older ones, you know. My personal favorite one is Godzilla vs. King Kong, which I talked about in my contest video, or show at least. This one, it's really, really good. I used to watch it a ton as a kid, and it was weird and funny and strange when I used to watch it as a kid. And it's even weirder and stranger when I watched it as an adult, knowing that they took an already subbed movie, dubbed it with this bizarre English track, and added their own American scenes, which was kind of funny. But yeah, so I don't know, like, I have nothing to rant about today. So it's kind of odd, because I'm not really angry about anything, you know. I look forward to going to work, to be honest. The work itself is not so fun because of the you know, it's physically, you know, sometimes it can be physically demanding, and it can sometimes be boring. But the bright side of that, right, is that for every hour at work, I earn money. There's no doubt about that, you know. And plus, I get to be social. I get to talk to customers. I get to see pretty ladies sometimes. You know, that's always a plus. You know, especially my the Walgreens I work at, predominantly Chinese neighborhood, which is nice. I get to talk to coworkers. Mess around with them, play with them, that kind of stuff, you know. It's kind of fun too. When I play with them, I mean, just like joke around and stuff. I'm a boss, so I have to be serious too, you know. And so they cannot be too jokey, it cannot be too funny either. So it's just the right amount of joking, right amount of this and that, you know, just so that things don't get weird and stuff, you know. But I do like my team. I do like this crew. It's just a difference. This is just a totally different feeling from like Staples. You know, at Staples, it was, we were friendly and stuff, but it just never felt, it felt phony to me, especially South City Staples. San Francisco Staples felt a little bit more family-like because we were a smaller team, and it felt like we could complain to each other, that kind of thing. But the South City one, we're a big team, bigger team, and it was a sinking ship, you know. And so, to me, it just felt like it was such a downer working there. You know, mentally I was tired, physically I was even more tired. I don't know why, because this job here I do is much, much more demanding physically, you know. But I guess when your mind is very tired all the time and you have to still do a lot of physical work, it's just like a double drain, man. And sometimes at the end of my day, at South City Staples, I would just want to do nothing. I just want to just go lie down and watch TV, and that's it, you know. I'll try to be creative during that time, and that's when those stupid, ugly-ass videos came out, you know? God, those early videos are horrible, man. I'm gonna leave them up there as a reminder, just because, you know, what I used to be, you know, compared to now, I was like 10,000 times better. But yeah, I'm so happy to have this. I'm grateful, that's a better word, to have this job. It's nice. It's nice. But yeah, other than that, a couple new things about my videos. I decided to make title cards, a title card, to make them more movie-esque. And because I learned how to do that while I was doing my contest video, which is really helpful. But yeah, this is going to be a little bit shorter one than my usual 15 to 18 minute ones because my mind's tired today. It actually is. And it took a long time to edit the other one, which was just fun, you know? It's fun, but still tiring. And this is just one I just want to get done tonight. And then after this, I'm going to go lie down and watch TV and go to sleep. I have to wake up early tomorrow. Anyways, guys, please like, please subscribe. You know the deal. And I want to say thanks a lot for everything, you know, and see you tomorrow.